Hello again, I'm Larry Hamilton. Thank you for watching. Today we're going to do a watercolor painting of a small country church in a winter scene. And I think this is one that may or may not be used in one of my watercolor sessions, but I thought I would record it anyway and let you try to paint along with me or paint it after I'm finished. And I have a sketch of the painting here already completed, as you can see, and I'll get it zoomed in just about right so you can see as much as you can with this camera. And I'll take a couple minutes to go over our brushes and our paints again, and we'll get started on this. So what I want to do is get my water containers open and tell you we have three flat brushes, a 1-inch flat, a 1/2-inch flat, and a 1/4-inch flat. I have 4 round brushes. I have a number 12, a number 8, a number 4, and I have a number 6 rigger. I also have a calligraphic marking pen here, a calligraphic pen that we may use for some of the fine lines. I don't know. I may try it and see how it works. I've learned a new technique on using this pen with watercolors, and so we may try that in after when we get to the final stages of the painting. Okay, the paints, same as last time. These are My Merry Blue watercolor paints. We have, in this corner, we have neutral tint, very much like a Payne's gray. We have cyan blue, ultramarine blue, ultramarine violet, crimson lake, which is similar to alizarin crimson, garnet lake, which is a little bit browner violet. We have cadmium red, burnt sienna, raw sienna, and yellow ochre. I have cupric green, which is similar to a viridian, very dark staining color. I have golden lake, which is also similar to a raw sienna, but a slightly browner look. I have a couple of yellows, yellow, lemon yellow, and primary yellow, which is more like a cad yellow. On this inside row, I have burnt umber, sap green, Avignon orange, primary red magenta, and still-to-grain brown. So that's our colors, and those are our brushes. We're going to be painting on 14 by 20 cold-pressed, 140-pound cold-pressed watercolor paper. And we're going to see if we can do this scene some justice. It's a painting that I watched an artist paint last week. He took nearly 7 hours to do this painting, six plus hours to do the painting. I don't expect to spend nearly that much time on it, but I should be able to get it done in a couple hours is my hope. And if I do, we'll be successful. I'm going to get some water here to just start wetting the paper. And I'll start with my big 1-inch brush, and we're going to wet down at the top here. Again, as you know, I'm painting vertically on this easel that I have set up here, which is very unusual for watercolor painters to paint vertical, simply because the water runs down and it can make a mess if you're not careful. So I'll try to be as careful as I can, but I may get some runs here and there, but that's not a big problem. There are ways to correct watercolor. And if we keep a paper towel handy, we can usually keep most of the runs from getting to be too wild and crazy. Just want to get this paper reasonably wet all the way across the sky. And we'll start down with the background first as soon as I get it wet. Paint carefully along here. These square brushes are, flat brushes rather, are really great for going around architectural objects like buildings and houses, churches, whatever you may have that has sharp edges. And that should give us some wet paper. We'll let that paper soak for just a few seconds here. going to start out with a color that I want in this sky that sort of underlays everything, called Raw Sienna. So while this is soaking, I'm going to mix up a small batch of Raw Sienna. Check it out, make sure I've got water everywhere I want it right now. And we'll start with our Raw Sienna mixture here. Put a light coat of Raw Sienna over the sky, and then we're going to come back and put some darker clouds in. Still using this big 1-inch brush. And I need a little more paint. I have two water containers, one for clean water and one for dirty water. Try to keep them separate and keep them from getting mixed. Sun is going to be coming from the left side in this painting, so the sky over here is going to be slightly warmer than it is on the right side, but we don't want to leave the right side out, so I'm going to put a little of this Raw Sienna over there. All right, so that's good for that part of it. Now I want to go back and get myself some Payne's Gray, maybe a little ultramarine blue, and see what kind of a sky. I'm going to have a fairly dramatic sky in this painting. It has a lot of dark clouds and sort of a bluish color. So starting up here, let's get that water out. Up here we're going to have fairly dark clouds. All the way across, pretty much. And these are going to be soft edges because we want to have the sky should always be soft. Clouds are soft. We try to keep our edges soft. That may be enough for that. Over here, let's see if I've got a little rough edge over there. That's all right. I may leave that. Touch a little down in here with give myself just a little of the alizarin. Give myself a little lavender color here. We're going to have some purple in this. Quite a bit. Most snow scenes do seem to have a lot of shadows that have sort of a purple cast to them. We'll be putting trees in over here. Okay. Darken that up in a little bit. Let's get it soft. Make sure we have soft edges on the bottoms. Like that. Okay. Up here, I'll put in maybe a couple more touches of sky. Have a few mountains in the distance. So I'll leave that. Have that color over here. All right. It's not too bad. Let me pick up a little water here.
One thing with a dry, thirsty brush, you can usually pick up the water and it doesn't cause you too much trouble when it starts to run. Okay. I think that's all I want to do for that part of the sky. I'm going to get my hairdryer out here to sort of blow this and try to dry it a little faster. Excuse the noise. Okay. All right, let's look at the mountains on the right side. They're going to have some this ultramarine violet in them. So I'm going to hit those now while this is still... Something like that. Put some darker colors in there. Maybe get a little neutral tint in there. Need more paper towel. Excuse me. I'm just laying the brush on its side pretty much, not... Some rough edges in there in some places. That is supposed to be snow on the ground back there. I may come back and get that, make that a little darker after a bit. Let that run. Okay. On the left side, I'm going to get some, let me get a little bit thinner brush. Going to get a half inch brush here and start working on some trees. These trees are going to have a little bit of dark color from the distance, and this area back here we want to have some dark trees. That's not quite dark enough, I don't think. A little burnt umber in there, mix it with ultramarine, I'll get a dark gray, a brownish gray. These are going to be distant trees, fairly distant. Change the color. Interesting shapes. Using the corner of a flat brush and get you some shapes that look like pine trees off in the distance. Against this tree like this. Over here we're going to have some more of that. Change the color. I get a little bit more blue in this, maybe over here. I'm painting around branches of this tree. I'm also leaving room to put some snow in some places. And over here. Got some blue up there. Get rid of that blue. Okay. Try a little change of color. This a little lighter here if I can. Pick up some color. Make it look like it's got some foggy mist in the distance. I'll put another layer over this so I can get this to look sort of misty back here in the distance. That's what I want. So I'm just taking a dry brush, taking some of the water out of it, and just pushing up. We're able to get this nice misty looking background here. And something like that. Okay. Hopefully that's starting to show up well. Let me, you can always tell if something's dry by putting your finger on the back of your finger on the paper, and if it's the temperature of your finger, it's dry. If it feels cool, it's still wet and you want to leave it alone. On the right side over here, we have some more trees that I want to try to drop in. I get some browns, get a little of this still-to-grain brown, touched in a bit of sap green along with this lavender color, purple color over here. Start putting in some trees, something it looks like. We got little pine trees sticking up over here. Using the corner of the brush, coming back, getting a little more paint that's not quite as watery. Take some of the water out of the brush. You can always touch the brush and take the take some water out of the back by the furrow and get a darker color in there, which is what I want right now. It's going to lighten up. So we're just making an interesting little background over here. That look like trees sort of in the shadow or in the silhouette, actually. And we'll blend the bottom of those a little bit. Touch some water. Okay. Getting some brown in here in some spots. It's a little bit too much brown, but we'll fix it. Leave some room for some tree branches here. Over here, we'll put a little bit of brown trees. I want to be all brown over there. I want to have a little brown on the left. So it's painting this distant section. This is pretty far back. A little more room for another branch. Change the color. Change the size. Change the everything I can think of. If I can think of it. A little tree in here maybe. Something like that. Okay, so that's starting to give us some small trees in the distance. A little bit of texture back there. Okay, I'll leave that for now. I'm going to come back and put a few more things in there, I think. Maybe I'll bring some of that down here right now. Just paint around a few things. I remember to come back and pick them up again. Fairly nondescript back there. We don't want a lot of attention paid. Let's just put some more, pull it together. All right, I'll leave that alone for now and see what it looks like after a while. Maybe I'll come back and hit it again, but right now I'm going to leave it alone. On this other side where these trees are, this is dry over here now, so let's go back and get some more ultra violet, a little bit of a still to grain brown, and a little bit of neutral tint. Oh, right in here somewhere I want another tree similar to the ones over there on the other side, a little taller. So I'm just touching it in, moving the flat end of this brush back and forth, sort of in a Z pattern. I want to bring it down here somewhere in this area. So these trees have to have a darker, have to be darker because they're closer than the trees behind them. So that's the reason for the darker paint. And you get paint darker by taking the water out or putting more pigment down in the palette and having worn a brush. You can take water out of the brush by touching the bottom of the brush. So I'll put a few more things back here that look like some trees going on, and maybe in front of that we'll have a few more things sticking up here. Okay, dry the brush out and see what happens when I do this. Okay, it gives me some nice distant feeling there of something soft. I'm going to put some more bushes here in the foreground. Wet it down a little bit first. This area I've already have some color in it. Slide over here. Let's touch a little bit of some kind of greenish color we can get out of this. Over here. Still painting around these tree branches. Could put masking on, but I decided I wasn't going to do that. And I think this is going to be snow back here, so I'm going to leave it rough, some rough edges on the bottom. And Okay. Pick up some. Okay, that's starting to look like a field in the distance of some sort. I think it looks pretty good on the camera, so I'll leave that for now. A little bit of blue up here. I don't know if I can fix it or not, but it's bothering me. All right, I can put some more closer bushes and things in here if I feel like it after a while. I think I'm going to put a little more dark back here. This is not quite standing out like I want it to. I'm going to have to let that dry. I think it's too wet. Okay. About the roof of this house, or of the church. Roof is sort of a dark, at least part of it's in shadow here. So we're going to start right up here. Again, I'm using a half inch flat. Change the color. Don't let it stay the same. Painting around snow here. It's going to be left on this roof. Dark using ultramarine blue and neutral tint. Then on the other side, we're going to start here, but I'm going to start pulling in some more, a little bit of lavender with some alizarin in it to redden that roof up a little bit. Leaving room for snow in here. Starting to look pretty good. Let me look over here on this eave on this side. And as with most buildings, you want to have some sort of a light color coming up from the bottom to represent reflected light. So I'm going to drop a little bit of a orangey-brown color in here while that's still wet and see if I can get a beautiful blend going up this way, something like that. Okay. This other roof is dark. I almost need my quarter-inch brush for that guy. Let me see here. Where did it go? Yeah, let's try the quarter-inch brush, quarter-inch flat. Working on this little piece of roof over here. And it's going to get darker as it comes down the side here. Slight. And I want to have a little bit of lighter color coming up. A reflected light. Over here, this side, I got a little bit of a brown color. Okay, the bottoms of these need to be soft. Make a hard edge soft by just putting some water in it and dragging it out. Okay. So that's starting to look interesting, if not perfect, but it's starting to take on the colors that I want. Front of this church has more yellow in it. I'll see if I can get some. I'm using this CAD yellow to lighten up my browns a little bit. And I don't think I want to use that small of a brush. I want to use my, half-inch brush. A little bit of lavender, get this ultramarine violet in here. So I've got ultraviolet and I've got some of this brownish color on the top of the eave up here. I'm going to start with this probably too light. But I can go back over it and darken it. I'm going to mix in some of this color. Just happen to have a half inch on each side of that window that makes that work. Some other colors here underneath the window. We got some snow down here, so I'm going to leave some rough texture at the bottom. Okay. And this wall of the building here should be about the same color because it faces the same direction. So I'm going to do that now while I've got this paint in my brush. Might be a little darker because it could, part of it will be in shadow back here. Change color. Colors aren't as important as values. If you get the values right, colors don't matter quite as much. Painting a realistic building, however, you want to have some consistency in at least what should be somewhat realistic. You don't want it to be some odd shape unless you're doing a sort of an impressionistic painting. And this top of the building up here, top of this, should be very similar. It's all part of the same brick structure, if you will, around this. Half-inch flat brush. Okay. Oh, I got my finger in it. Don't like that when it happens. But I'll paint over that, so that's not a big problem. All right. How are we doing on time here? I think I've been going about 30 or 40 minutes, maybe, if my internal clock is right. Okay, inside here, this wall. Got some snow on top of this little roof here. Sticks out, so I want to make allowance for that. Okay, got myself an interesting little background here. You know what a background is? It's this little area here that has some, had too much water in my brush and it actually ran back over, made a hard edge in there. However, I'm going to put some bricks and things in here, so that's not going to be too much to deal with. Okay, this little building actually has, it's actually a wood attachment here. Change the color, change the value. The value is what tells you what's going on. Needs to be darkened just a little. Okay. All right, how about roof on top of the little protrusion needs to be dark with ultra blue and neutral tint. This roof here, it's got to be darker than what's behind it so it stands out. That's not quite dark enough. Get some more paint in the brush, take some of the water out. That's pretty close. When I'm not talking, I'm usually thinking. It's hard to talk and paint at the same time because it forces you to use both sides of your brain. The left side of the brain is more used for talking and analyzing and looking at shapes, and the right side is used to make things look artistic. So I'm going to work on this part of this face of the church. Not going to be dark enough, but I will come back and darken it more later. Put some browns in there. And because that's the the plane of the building that goes out of the sun, this needs to be darkest here. And it needs to be darker. So we'll get some more ultra blue that will darken it up a little. Around this window. Probably wouldn't have to paint around those windows if I didn't want to, but that's not dark enough. There, it's getting darker. The underside of this E, that's too wet to mess with over there. How's this doing over here? I've been painting all over my hands. Clean this off a little. Alright. I think I'm going to have to stop and change my tapes, so I'll be back in a moment. Actually, I had a little more time than I thought. I have about another 15 minutes on my tape here. I have a 1 hour, 60-minute tape in one of my cameras. The other cameras are digital and don't require a tape, so I just have to worry about my one camera. So if I keep track of my time, I will stop in about 15 minutes and change my tape. I'm going to paint right over this little door. And hopefully remember to come back and put it in. Okay. A lot of snow there. We got some. Partially over some of these windows here. Okay. I'm about spending a little time on this steeple back here with my little quarter inch flat brush. If I can put in some dark colors on it. Paint the steeple in up here. It doesn't have to be real dark to stand out from the sky behind it because I've left white back there. Same color for some of this area. I have a window there that I should come back and put in. Maybe a little darker down here. A little bit of clear water here. And on top, we'll put this little ridge. Let it run down a little bit. Okay. Actual front of this building. And we need a dark eave under here. Let's get a little bit of this water out of here before it sets up. Just pulling that down without putting any paint in my brush left a nice sort of a gray looking front on that building, or on that steeple. Up here, I'm going to blend this together and leave it for a little bit. Put a little bit of this reddish brown if I can get it on top of that roof right here. Some more backgrounds over there. Okay. So, what do I have time to do? I think maybe put in some darker accents on the side of this protrusion here, this building that sticks out, to make it look like wood. darken this side even more. Okay. Thinking that's looking pretty good. How about let's get a few more trees and some bushes in this area beside the church. Get myself some evergreen color here. I'm using a little sap green with neutral tint. See what I can put in here. Something like that, make a little change in color. Change the color, add some browns here and there. Adding brown with some red in it. Over here, maybe some of the same, only not quite as distinct. Lost my evergreen color. Okay. And I want to make it look like this all goes together. Okay. Something like that. We'll give ourselves some interesting middle ground colors there. All right. I'm thinking my tape is very close to being out, so I'm going to stop, take a break, clean my palette, and get some more water, and I will be back in short order. Okay, we're back and ready to try to finish this painting off. I got some clean water and cleaned out my brushes, and I'm ready to continue here. All right, let's see what we can do with a little bit of this bridge, maybe. I think I'll work on the bridge a little bit. Let me get my half inch flat, and I want to get some of this reddish color in here. We need a little bit of red or reddish brown for this bridge. I don't want it to be the same color as the building. It's got to be a little darker because it is in shadow. So I'm going to work on my palette here, getting sort of a lavenderish color that's darker than what I put on so far, with adding basically a couple of my reds, Crimson Lake and Cad Red, along with some ultramarine blue. I'm just mixing up a
interesting color here.
And we'll see what it looks like when I start going here.
Looks like the same color that I've had other places. Change the color. I'll try a little bit of this Garnet Lake. It's a little bit browner color. And stick in some still to grain brown and see what that does. Aha. Now I'm painting the top edge of this is going to be snow. Some of the under edge along this tree is going to be snow, but some of it is not going to be snow. So let's do this. Get myself a little more ultra neutral tint. And I want some more brownish red in here, maybe a little yellow to lighten it up at the bottom. Didn't lighten it up very much. So we'll so I got nice variegated colors there. Coming back and putting in some more of this bridge. Change the color, change the shape. Keep the value pretty much the same. It's the trick. However you can do that. So you're picking up a little bit of green down here.
It's a little mossy look. And it all touches the snow.
More brown in there. I get some burnt sienna. A little yellow ochre or one of these earth colors of yellow ochre, raw sienna, and burnt sienna. Something like that. Let's get some other colors in here.
Painting around the bottom of this tree. So I'm doing the bridge and some of this bank over here that's got a lot of brown foliage on it. Something like that. Okay. Put that green in that bridge, and I don't have it anywhere else. I gotta make sure that I don't leave that as the only place with some of that olive green in it. I did try to put some up here, but I want to have some over here as well. This would be some evergreen type things floating around over here. I don't know what they are, but try to put them in. Okay, now underneath this bridge we've got a nice little highlight. It goes from cool to warm up here, and then in the back underneath it we have this interesting soft lavender color. So if it was a place to work in my palette here, I got some too many colors in there. So I'm going to make myself a small pile of lavender. Go back and get some clear water in my brush. And in this area here, I want it to be soft, so I'm going to put in some clear water. Right under this reflection. Try to pull this down into the snow and some other stuff that sets back under this bridge. So let's just take some ultraviolet on top of that water and see what happens. I'll give a nice soft look back there. And then it's going to move into something a little darker here. So I'm just picking up this color that I had for parts of the bridge. And we're going to make a few shapes of something back there. Just gives the look and feel of something distant. I still almost have too hard an edge on the top of this here, but let's see if I can soften it a little more. Not too bad. Okay. Stop with that or I'll run it. Okay, what do we got now? So this is all snow in here. I can maybe put in some modeling in the snow. So I'm just using ultraviolet. Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll stop with that. Right side, this building over here, I haven't done anything with yet. So let's work on that guy. Let me get some of this dark. Need a roof that's dark but leaves room for snow. So I'm going to use my neutral tint again. And just touch in some of that. Have to add some ultra blue with it to get it dark enough. And that's still not very dark. Too much water in my brush, probably. There you go. So that's going to have just a hint of a roof. It should look like there's snow left on top. Front face of that's going to have a brown color, similar to what I've used before. Mix up my colors. Okay, that could be darker at the top. Could be darker right here on the edge. Okay, just let that run and see what happens. There's all snow under here. Background, I'm going to go get some more of this ultraviolet. Okay, pulling that forward. So much for that. This area here, I'm going to go back to my quarter inch brush because I'm going to need to thin it. I have a very thin top on it. Darker. And I want to start graying it off a little bit into a okay, that should be showing. hopefully that looks good in the video as a nice reflection coming underneath that bridge. That's the idea. Okay, we still have some more work to do on the building, church, and the buildings behind it. I think this eave needs to be put in. Let's see here if I can keep from getting my hand in it. I just put my hand in it. That's what I didn't want to do. And okay. Windows in. I will come back and touch those up some more, but right now I want to just get a base color over them. There's also a snow on this little outbuilding here. Okay, that should help with that. At the top of this steeple, it's dry. Uses a lot of lavender. Snow has a lot of lavender color in it. Snow can actually have all kinds of colors in it because it reflects a lot of what's around it. It's all up here. mixture of colors here. Between the ultra violet and some of my browns. Soften that bottom edge with clear water. Because if I want to connect something to it, I want a soft edge. And over here. Okay, that's starting to shape up. Let's see. That's pretty good. I'm not gonna do much more with that. I'm gonna come in and start putting in some of the water as it comes forward. I think maybe it's time to take on one of these trees. And this tree on the left side is big enough, I think I can use my half-inch brush. So I'm going to get a nice couple of shades of brown. Brown with some yellow in it to lighten up the side that's closest to the sun. A bit darker brown for the middle. And then I'm going to add some ultra, or neutral tint to it rather. And maybe a little of this ultraviolet to give me the darkest side. So I'm going to have like three shades of brown here. And I'm going to start with putting in some of this on the along here. Make sure I don't get my hand in something. Change the color a little bit. The right side should be darker. Some brown in there. We got to make sure we have definite dark colors to make this branches stand out from the background. All right, keep working on that. Okay. Okay, a lot of detail in here. That's why I'm not talking. I'm leaving little spots in there that try to make it look like there might be some snow hanging around on these branches. I still have to make them stand out so you know what they are. This has to be darker. Where was I? Okay, there. Up here, we've got some running into gray up here. And we'll put a few things on there to kind of tie that together before I'm finished, I hope. If I don't forget. All right, hopefully that's looking like a big old tree over there on the left side. And is not too hard to distinguish. I do have some more of this. Put in some more snow in some areas here. Shadows under the snow. Okay, stop on that for a while. A little bit of that goes a long way. And we'll come back and put some fine branches and things in there. This area over here is all sort of a violet color as well. Sort of blends into some greenish color for the water. Big old brush out here and put in some clear water and we'll blend this all together. Okay, keep getting these marks from the brush in there, which I don't like, but if the paper's wet enough, it'll blend together, hopefully. Okay, stop on that. Got a similar situation on the right side over here, where we have quite a bit of gray or violet. Just loading it on here. Change the color a little bit, add some because I softened that edge before. I didn't leave a hard edge up here, so it should blend together nicely. Okay, foreground is pretty well done. So we need to have a little. And similarly, take out some of the whites in there, make it. Let's see here. So we got bushes and things to put in here. I have another tree that goes up behind these houses. Let me work on these small houses in the background here on the right side. Get myself some ultra blue, some gray. Ultra blue and burnt sienna will make an interesting gray. I don't know if I've even tried that yet today, but I'm going to put a little bit in here right now and see what we can do with this little house on the right side. Except I can't put my hand in it. A little roof. Side of the building, one stroke. Fix that run up to the head. Another background over here that I left hanging. Let that set for a moment. All right, probably gonna have to get out this quarter inch brush because I've got a lot of small spaces on this one building because I got a tree that runs through it. So, should I put the tree in first, the building? Let's see. I'm going to put the front of this other building in first over here. My tree is going to get some attention first. Take this tree through the roof of this building, but I'm gonna try the old lost and found edge trick and see if that works. Okay, these are... And this area that goes through the roof is going to be... left unpainted. I will try to paint around it. A little door in over here. Drop in some darker paint, that'll work. Have to be darker over there. Okay. Good enough. This building, the next building over, is going to have a gray front. And the side's going to be just a little bluer. Excuse me. I think we're doing okay here. Let's let that dry a little bit. Come back and try some of this color in these windows. And that needs to be blurred a little. Blur that a little. Okay. The door of this church is sort of a reddish brown. And it can be a little darker. Thank you. another door that I about forgot about. It's in here. Be darker, it needs to be darker. So outline this window a little bit here. Okay, same thing goes up above. Roof needs to be darker than whatever's around it. Now let's do a little bit of work on this building with the behind the church. Still have a door opening there that I want to put some light in. Okay. Putting in some rough edges here, side of the brush. These are bushes and things that are got snow on top of them. I want rough edges at the bottom. Okay, making progress here. Two there, make a couple different sizes. Make some of them lean. And join it in the ground. Change the color. Made a mistake there. Pick it up. Paper towels are wonderful for that. So if I make these edges at the bottom of these posts soft, they look like they sort of just go right into the snow, which is what I want. Okay, that side of the painting is getting pretty well done, except for some fine tuning with the script liner or my calligraphic pen. Still have some whites floating around there, but I think I'm gonna enough. Okay. soft edges. Sometimes you want soft edges, sometimes you want rough edges. Okay, we have another. Actually, we have more bushes and things underneath that fence line than I show. So let's see what we can put in here. More bushes. Should be soft. All right, how's that looking? Looks like I'm running out of tape again. I don't know why. My camera tells me I'm running out of tape, so I better stop it. Okay, we are back, and I think we've gone about 2 hours of video so far, so we're going to try to finish this off hopefully in the next 30 minutes thereabouts, pretty close. So I've got a lot of the background done, maybe a few places I could work on here, but got a lot of that done. Most of the church is done. I have some fine details to put in there. I'm going to go and put in this water that we have in the underneath the bridge. And I'm going to try to get a good dark green color. The water is almost black in some areas, as it usually is in sometimes in winter scenes, the snow scenes at least. Water appears to be very dark and almost black in many cases. So I'm going to be mixing up a really dark mixture here of something that looks like it might be good for the water, and we'll try it and see how that works. Let me get some paper towel in my left hand. I usually try to work paper towel in my left hand because I'm painting vertically. I really need to control the water. Something like this. Needs to remain very dark. On this right side over here, I'm leaving some space for snow. I've got some dark violet in there, and I'm going to put some other shadows in and make it look like there's snow on the banks here. And as we bring this forward, that something like this. Actually, starts getting more green and even some yellow in it in the, as we come to the foreground over here. Here, get some lighter color, paint around my peg. Okay, something like this. And while we're at it, need to pop in some of these reflections going this way. Vertical strokes make things look like water. Want hard edges in there. Okay. Okay, that's getting a little bit like I want it. So we can come in and put in some other darks and fix this up. As we put some snowbanks on it. Okay. Okay, that's gonna have to hold for now. Got some more of these bushes in the right foreground. I'm going to get myself some burnt sienna, a little bit of neutral tint, and maybe some blue, so I can get several shades of brown and gray and dark colors. I think I'm going to put some yellow ochre in here. So I have several shades of brown leading to a dark, and still using a half inch flat brush. And over in this area, I'm going to lay this brush on its side and sort of push up. Need a little thicker paint here. Dry it out. There we go. something like that. Put some darker marks at the bottom. Just putting some things in the foreground here to give it some interest. A few more places back in here maybe to sort of tie things together. Just sort of touching and in some cases pulling up. Pretty well done. This is done. I think I'm going to put a little more darkness in that. Get my quarter inch brush inside this little building at the back of the church. Add a few some dark spots back there. Up. All right. Windows in the church here. Let's see what I can do with these guys. That. So I'll pick it up. This building attached to the church, that little one that sticks out, just to be a little darker right here. Make that door stand out. Change the color if I can remember. Okay. It helps. Some dark, a little bit of this burnt sienna. See if I can come in and touch in a few more spots in this bushes down here. Brush has got too much water in it. Something like that. And then over here, I need to have, it looks like to me, the color of this bridge sort of continues on past this tree. That's not dark enough. In here, and then even over here. Something like that. Okay, that helps outline that tree a little better and the branch associated with it. Just trying to find places where I need to darken up to help the contrast, identify what's around, like the tree here. So I either have to get lighter or darker here. I think I'm going to get darker, since it's, you can always get darker, but you can't get lighter many times in watercolor, so I'm going to put in something fairly dark back here. And I'll bring it over here. If you do that, it connects it together and it says, oh, that does go behind that tree. And while I'm at it, I got to do over here as well. Start varying the color a little bit, maybe pull some red in it or other colors, but it still has to be dark. Now all of a sudden that tree branch shows up. That. And I should probably soften it a little bit so that it doesn't look like it's glued on. Those take some wet water, take some water on the edge of the brush and just dry the brush and lift up. You get some interesting effects. Gotta dry the brush first, however. Okay. Maybe I need just a little bit over here. It's going to blend into that background above it. Okay, not too specific. Keep it somewhat abstract. Okay, that's going to end up finishing that off, I think. I got to put in some light branches. I still have another window to fill in over here, and I'm going to try to get a little of the sunlight hitting this window here. Sort of getting the sunlight, and I'll mix some purple with it at the bottom, which will cool it down a little bit. And I'll let that dry, and I'll come back and put in some things that look like window markers or the panes of the window is what I'm trying to say. Okay, I'm just touching in now some very light vertical horizontal strokes with this to sort of highlight the edges of some things. I don't want to draw this like calligraphy here, but I want it to stand out so you know there's a object like a window or a door or something like that. Up above here, this window could use a little bit. Just a touch makes it look three-dimensional. That's what we're trying to do. Here, I'll make that a gray color instead of a brown color. It helps to make these nice straight edges once in a while. Helps us make the thing look more three-dimensional, more realistic. Something like that all helps. Here I get my quarter inch brush out. I'm going to do something similar to this steeple. If I can get it so I can distinguish between the two planes here, between this plane a little to define that, those edges. Shadow in here. help shadow under this thing. So I'm not putting this line everywhere. I'm not drawing these lines. I'm just touching with the brush certain areas to highlight certain edges. And the eye will fill in the rest of that. So you don't have to paint in every window pane and every... Just have to highlight certain things, and lo and behold, you have interesting... Up here I've got branches that I want to extend. Something like that. I'm going to come back and get my old rigger here if I can find it. Maybe I'll get this number four round. See if I can get a nice sharp point on it. And hopefully it will paint in the kinds of branches that I want and my detail up here. So I'm just doing fine calligraphic details, they're called. Make it look like there's a lot of old branches hanging on. This is a live tree at one point. Just lost a lot of its leaves right now. Winter. Something like that. Maybe another couple. No, don't like that too well. Have more of this type of stuff on the big tree on the left. Thinking I gotta have something more in here to help fill it out. It just didn't look quite right to me. There are some interesting details on in front of that church, so I may come back there and put some of those in. Up. Some nice dry brush going on here. In some things on the left that make it look like there's some leaves kind of hanging around. Dry brush here really does wonders for bark. A little stump that's been cut off. Okay, getting very close to being finished. Got a few more things to put in the windows here and here. This little church has a cross emblem right here. And it has a little cross up here on top of the steeple. Okay, I think that's very close to what I want to have. Spend a lot more time on it with fine-tuning details and putting more texture in for places like the this bridge and the building. Like this. Just horizontal scraping this brush. Nope, I don't like that. Let's see. Up here. Okay, I think it's about all the damage I can do. I did want to put in a few things that look like some snow or some, it's not snow, but shadows here floating along the edge. I don't know if I can make that work or not. Let's see. Here there might be some shadows coming down to show that drops down toward the water. Still using this little number 4 round brush, which could be using a different brush, but right now let's see if I can make this work. So these shadows are what make the bank look rounded, hopefully. Let me model the snow. If that's looking right or not. Let's get one of these little bigger brushes and see if I can feather that out. Yeah, it needs to be darker over here, probably all the way through. And some more of these vertical streaks that look like that's water. Vertical streaks tell the eye that this is, we're getting reflections. Okay. Maybe I have a little more gray on the right side here. Let's see, I don't know. Okay, I think that's about all I'm going to do to this little painting. I might have missed a spot or two, but pretty much that's what I wanted to put in there. There's just a little bit here that I can maybe tie this together a little bit. Some hard edges and soft edges. Edges. Snow's a little difficult to paint in watercolor because so much of it has to be left unpainted or has to have different colors in it that you wouldn't expect. But that is a reasonable facsimile of what I started with, and hope you like it, and I hope you tune into more of my painting classes, and hope you'll take a subscription or subscribe to my YouTube videos, and when I post one, you will get a notification in your email. So again, until I see you again, I'll say thanks for watching and hope you enjoy this painting. So long.